Hi, my name is Steve Curtis. I work within Microsoft's Global Accounts Group and I focus in on the Dynamics line of business products. And today we're going to see how a combination of Dynamics CRM together with SharePoint and Yammer can provide very, very strong HR self-service capabilities to our global accounts. Over on the left-hand side, we can see that in this HR portal, there are corporate announcements, there's top-rated articles. Over on the right-hand side, there's a collaborative social feed using Microsoft's Yammer tool. And over in the middle here, we can see that there's new information that's coming through, maybe video-based information, PowerPoint information, etc., that can be made available. Now, I'm logged on at the moment as Alex Darrow. Alex Darrow is a marketing assistant working for Fabricam. And Alex has come onto the HR self-service portal because he's had a very, very positive piece of news. His wife's expecting a baby. And as a result of this, he wants to find out a little bit more about parental leave policies. So down at the bottom, you can see that there's groupings of different documents from the knowledge base. And this is sorted into benefits, career, policy and topics, and savings and investments. And since he's interested in one of the policies to do with parental leave, Alex decides to drill down into the policies and topics area. Now, this gives him a very nice view over on the left-hand side, a tree structure of all of the different documents that are available to him. In this particular area, you can see a set of documents, and these documents are rated and rateable by the employees. Here you can see the number of ratings that have been delivered. But as well as being able to go down the tree structure to find the documents that he needs, Alex can also use the very, very powerful search capability that's built into SharePoint. And all of this is standard product. So the search capability allows him to be able to filter down by document type, Excel, PowerPoint, video, by author, and then potentially by the last date that this was modified. And over in the middle here, we can see the documents themselves. And as Alex decides to look at each of these documents, he can mouse over the documents. And then on the right side, it will show a preview of the document concerned. So here we've got a Word document about parental leave. And maybe further down here, interestingly, there's a PowerPoint. And again, if you mouse over this, it brings out a preview of not just the first slide of the PowerPoint, but it also gives Alex the ability to click through those PowerPoint slides and be able to see the information that's held therein. And this helps him to decide what the critical documents are that he needs to be able to then download. Going back into the parental leave document, he could click on this directly and open it. He can go over onto the right side and decide here to be able to open it. He can click here, download a copy, print this to PDF for subsequent consumption, and again, open out that document if he wants to. He can send that document via email to one or more potential recipients. It could potentially be his wife or himself for him to look at subsequently. Maybe he decides once he's looked at this document that there's still a few questions that he's got. He's got one to do with whether he can take that parental leave in multiple segments. So he decides at this point to escalate to HR. And the whole thing about the HR self-service portals is to try and give employees the right information that they need and the right level. But ultimately, you might get to a point where employees want to ask questions. And in this case, those questions would automatically drop into your CRM system and allow your HR self-service agents to be able to then deal with those questions. So in this case, what Alex is going to do is ask a question about parental leave. So what we'll say is, hi, looked at the documentation, but need to know if I can take parental leave in 2 seconds. Thanks. He now saves that. Now that then comes back and tells him, in this case, we can see the case created. Now, the reality is that in most HR systems, it will come back with some sort of response to say, yes, we've received it. and we'll respond to you within 48 hours or something like that. That again is completely configurable to suit your business. We're now going to change tack a little bit. We're going to leave the HR self-service portal, and we're going to see the receiving of that particular case by the HR agent. So what we've now done is we've gone into Dynamics CRM, and we're going into the service area of Dynamics CRM and putting on the hat of a customer service representative. We can see that there in the middle area here, we can see a wall of information that's coming through, and we can see that the parental leave question has come through as a new question. Now, this is now as if we are a customer service representative working within the HR division looking after employees. So we can now open out this parental leave question. What this now does is it opens out the case from Alex Darrow on parental leave. We can see the question itself embedded in the middle here, and we can see a process-based approach to resolving the case. So at the moment here, we're on the identification stage where we're simply looking at the case in question and deciding whether we as a caseworker are the right people to be able to deal with this. Now, if I want to, I can decide, yes, I'm going to take this. I will then assign it to myself. And now I'll start to research this particular case. Now, in researching a case, maybe what you want to do is to be able to go in and search for other articles. Maybe there's other documentation in the knowledge base that hasn't yet been released to the employees. Maybe there's new documentation. So what we'll do is we'll click here to be able to search in our knowledge base. And luckily, in this case, we've got some information on parental leave. So we're going to add that into the case that might be useful. And down here, then, we're able to show that knowledge base article and see what's available to be able to send back to Alex. And in this case, it looks like it might be very, very useful. There's a HR resources benefits site that, again, allows Alex to be able to see more information on parental leave. We'll take that article and we'll email that article back to Alex Darrow. We'll entitle this parental leave response. And we'll send that particular email back to Alex Darrow. Now, the response to Alex Darrow could be a number of things. You could be on a telephone call. You could be on an email, and all of that information is held automatically against the case. We can then go to the next stage, and the next stage is this particular case resolved. Now, this workflow is a very simple workflow or business process. You can make this more complicated if you want to. You can have more steps involved. That is part of the configuration of Dynamics CRM that's suitable for you and for your business. But in this case, we've sent the email back, we've found the right document, we're going to mark this as resolved. Problem has been solved. Resolution sent up to date documentation. Billable time, if that's what you want to track. And then we'll mark this as resolved. Okay, so just to reiterate what we've done is we've gone from a HR self-service portal. We've allowed the employee to be able to look through the portal and be able to find the relevant documentation. They've escalated the question to HR. That's created a case within Dynamics CRM. And the user interface for that case is then very, very easy for the knowledge worker to be able to use the HR department. I hope this has been useful, and I hope if there's any questions, please come back to me.